Mr. Willis, you know a thing or two about what makes a franchise successful. So why were you pleased to return? And thanks for doing so.
I was pleased to return because, well, let me, I'll say it a different way, and I'll tell you about why I was happy to come back. When we did the first film, it was very ambitious, and it's not often that they try to make a film that has romance, action, and comedy all in the same film. And I always thought that one part of it was going to have to get kicked out, but it stayed in, and it all stayed in. So this time, the writers just added more romance, more action, and more comedy. And when we all got back together, I think it was just about 2 years in between, or a year and a half in between, but when we started back to work, it was as if we had just seen each other the day before. Everybody was right, was already in character, and showed up ready to,
thank you,
ready to play. I like to work in ensemble casts. I like to work with this group of actors, especially. And I think we were very fortunate to get Tony Hopkins back, and Catherine Zeta-Jones, and Byung-Hun Lee, and the cast that we did the first film with. All we try to do all day long is just make each other laugh, and hopefully that gets onto the screen, and you'll find some of it funny as well. But I like working with all these actors. I'm a big fan of Sir Anthony Hopkins. Well, I try not to take it very seriously. It's just a difficult thing if you take yourself seriously, if you take what you're doing seriously. We're just all really just trying to be entertaining, and the action sequences and things like that are just part of a certain kind of entertainment. Not my favorite, but I like to try to make people laugh more than I like to fight in films. But I have done a lot of them. You're right. Thank you. Thanks very much. Thank you very much. Well, I do let the stuntmen take over. I don't do that many stunts. I would do the stunts if I could, but I am not allowed to ever be hurt.
There's something quite smart in deciding you don't want to be hurt, I think.
Oh, I wouldn't mind being hurt. I mean, I get hurt all the time, but I get scolded if I'm...
Mr. Willis, what would prove irresistible for you, which would get your desires tingling?
Tingling?
Yes. I like a tingle.
I could see that.
Yeah.
Cars, old cars. Yeah. I like vintage cars, and you can only drive them one at a time, so.
I wondered in your youth, since this is a franchise that's inspired by the DC world, in your youth, whether or not comic books played an interesting, significant, or mediocre part of your childhood, and if you were interested in comic books, which ones grabbed you and why?
I wasn't a comic book guy. I spent most of my time just outside playing. But no, not much of a connection to DC Comics. Unless you want me to just make it up.
No.
I'm a big DC Comic fan. Let me tell you, nobody's bigger than me with DC Comics.
Perish the thought. Perhaps it's because you were into outdoor pursuits, and I imagine sports,
yes,
that you've remained in such good shape, because people who do sports tend to stay in good shape, as you've proved.
Vanity plays a big part in staying in shape. I shout in key more than singing. There are a lot of really good singers in the world, and I'm very happy to let them handle all the heavy lifting of singing really well.
Why never any singing roles? Is that the same?
Well, it's I just can't stand to hear the sound of my own voice when I sing. It really is excruciating. Well, I'm fortunate in that I get to bring my family with me when I travel, and it would be impossibly unbearable for anyone I was working with if I didn't have my family with me, because I would just be moaning about that, and I have a little baby, and I like to hang out with her every day. I hope I answered your question. I don't think I heard all of it.
I think if you could give us a kind of recipe for a happy relationship,
Oh, Christ. Well, I don't know about that. Did I just say, oh, Christ?
It's okay, no one heard it.
Well, I would have to excuse myself from trying to answer that. I don't know what it is. I think that you have that attention must be paid to your family and your friends and how you treat them, and I don't think there's anything more important than that.
Well, from the male perspective,
is the boat going down? Is the boat sinking?
No, we're okay.
Did you hear that?
We just hit something small.
Okay.
I think it was a child.
Not a
anyway.
Boat.
So Willis, do you wish to discuss how you get a kick, which you obviously do, out of creating a franchise, especially a franchise that works globally?
Well, I seldom think about creating a franchise. That task is the producer's job, to make this film come together and to get everybody together and make sure they're there on time. The discipline of film is a specific thing. But if you want to talk about really difficult acting, it would be theater, because in theater it's all live and it's all happening right at the same time, and there's no second take, and it creates much more fear in your heart than working in films.
And Mr. Willis, of all the many roles you've played for that one time, is there one that you would truly be thrilled to return to?
Well, I was thinking about what my answer might be while I was listening to you guys talk. My favorite part of making films is the actual day-to-day process of getting in front of the camera and trying to make it seem lifelike and trying to make it funny, try to make it romantic. And all this is, I know, a big part of films. And it's the sales of it all, and it's the explanation of how we made the movie or how we did it. But my favorite part is actually making the movie and going to work every day.